And now to proof that fish may be a whole lot smarter than we give them credit for. A UC Santa Cruz professor has released the first known video of a fish using tools to feed itself. With more on this amazing fish tail caught on tape, we go to Action News reporter Mei Chow, who's live in our Salinas newsroom.
Aaron, this is both a scientific and love story, if you will. A UC Santa Cruz professor witnessing what few of us have seen underwater, being enamored, and going on a 15-year journey to find the fish that proved what he knew all along, that they are sophisticated animals. It's well documented that some animals know how to use tools. Chimpanzees use them to eat food, birds use them to build nests. But never before have we seen fish use tools to complete an action. That is, until now. This is footage by UC Santa Cruz professor and biologist Giacomo Bernardi, taken in Palau off Australia's Great Barrier Reef. It shows a male wrasse, or orange-dotted tusk fish, uses pectoral fin to uncover a clam under the sand. It then picks up the clam with its teeth and takes it to a rock wall. There, it hurls the clam against the rock to get its meal.
People had not really thought much about it in fishes that are considered very, you know, very unsophisticated and primitive.
Bernardi has been tracking down wrasse fish since 1996 after seeing the fish use tools during an underwater expedition in Florida. He says it was love at first sight.
It stayed with me for a long time. I was diving in Palau and I saw the same thing happening. I was really happy because I had been waiting for 15 years to see it again. And so I saw it one or two times. And then I said, this is remarkable, I should film it.
Bernardi, who specializes in evolutionary biology at UC Santa Cruz, says this is a remarkable example of how evolution gave these fish the ability to think and to figure out how to get to hidden sources of food.
It's expected when you look at apes and monkeys and dogs and dolphins, but then when you are going down the evolutionary scale, you're really not expecting that. And so when you start looking at fishes, which is what I do, then you observe very, very sophisticated behaviors that you are not expecting from these kind of animals.
Bernardi says this evidence gives fish more credit, something he's known since he was 3 years old.
Very amazing things happen in the animal world, and we just need to spend time. This is a lesson in taking time in observing things.
And patience paying off for Giacomo Bernardi. He's not quite done yet. He's off to French Polynesia next spring to find some more amazing fish. And he says he hopes to have an underwater reunion with the fish who is giving a good name for all fish. And you know, Aaron, these fish actually do live here in Northern California. There are three species, two of which, the señorita and the sheep's head. You can find them in Monterey Bay as well as the Monterey Bay Aquarium. So keep your eyes out.
And you know what's so much fun is to see how excited the scientists get about this. I mean, that's half the fun of a story like this. Anyway, thank you. Thank you, May. The video was actually taken 2 years ago, but this is the first time it's been released. Professor Bernardi's study was just published in the September 20th issue of the journal Coral Reefs.